Just let me know when.
Man.
Check out my coffee cup. No, I'm not sponsored by Stumac. I wish I was. It'd be nice. Maybe so. See, look, Stumac. They owe me money. No, I'm just kidding. They don't owe me money. But Stumac, if you're out there. All right. So that's my fret crowning file. Just showing everybody. And you can zoom in real quick on this. And this is that 1940 Gibson. I'm doing a fret level and dress. And there's not a lot to work with left on this thing, but I'll work with what I can. But you have to level them, recrown and shape them, and then sand them with 1000 grit sandpaper and polishing stones that I have, and get them back to their original shine. And I've already measured everything to make sure that they're leveled properly. And then I have to refit the nut and adjust the height of the nut to compensate for what I'm removing down here. This is the one that I said had my bent neck, is now straight. So I'm not going to tell you how I do that because that's my own little thing. But just wanted to put that on there real quick, and we'll see this thing when it's done. Bye. All right. Hello and welcome to Gibson Land. So here we are late at night. It's what's the clock say? 10:30, which is pretty late for someone that gets up at 3:45 in the morning almost every day. So anyway, happy Friday, since this is not Sunday. And the reason I'm doing this is because I have to deliver this Gibson to the customer tomorrow up at Sooner State Pond in Oklahoma City. And I wanted to share this with you guys because I had told you I would, so I keep my word. But this thing, I originally thought that this thing was a replica, a very good, well-built replica. But some very extensive research later, I've come to find out that I really don't know everything about it. So figure that out. But anyway, what I do know about it is a Gibson, and it is an L4, and it has the nice little label inside here that tells me that it's an L4. However, I have discovered that it is either one of two things. It is a 1940 or a 1946. So one would make it pre-war and one would make it post-war, obviously. And the difference between those two is quite a lot of money. But anyway, that being said, hello camera, there's a Gibson. So late at night, lots of coffee. And acting like a goober. So what I did was I had to straighten out the neck, which I told you I wouldn't tell you how I do that. Nothing odd about it, but I have my own little tricks and ways that I do those things. And the other thing I did was something that's very common, that is a fret level and dress. And there's not a lot of life left in these frets. There's probably one more fret dress left to them, and then they're going to have to be refretted. So in order to save the customer the cost of refretting it, I went ahead and did the frets, and you can see they're still got some life left in them, all nice and shiny and polished. And it originally it fretted out in this area and up here, and there was a hump in the neck right here. The neck was warped like that. And I, after leveling it and straightening out the neck and also readjusting the nut height, this is the original nut, readjusting the nut height and cutting the slots correctly, because that was part of the problem. This nut, one of the things that made me think it was a replica was the nut was not original. This has been replaced. It's a bone nut, and that's one of my specialties, is cutting bone nuts by hand. This one was done incorrectly. The slots were in the right place, but that was about it. So the strings would hang up. They didn't ride through the slots correctly at the proper angles and all that. And so I had to recut that, and I had to lift it up a little bit to do that. But it is correct now. Now it plays like a Gibson should play. These old arch tops are kind of a strange thing. They're sort of acoustic and sort of not. They used to put microphones in front of them. This one used to have a pick guard attached to it, and it would be a big pick guard right here. And a lot of the pick guards had a DeArmond pickup in it, or a Gibson pickup in it, mounted under the strings on the pick guard right here, and then give it kind of a jazz guitar thing. Being in the 40s, it was an early electrified thing, so they kind of didn't sound wonderful like they do now, but it was louder and it served its purpose. But they have a unique tone to them. They're not boomy like an acoustic guitar, even though they are technically an acoustic guitar, these arch tops and arch back, by the way. But they are an acoustic guitar, but they're not like you would think of an acoustic guitar now. They're very bright and very, very dim. At the same time, they're kind of a very focused mid-range sound, and not extremely loud. They're intended to be played with an up-close mic or very close to an audience, so you get that focused mid-range jazz sound. Stuff like that. Properly now. That was the biggest thing. The customer said, well, it doesn't really play right, and he was right, it didn't. One of the other things that was just kind of silly, I don't know, some people don't pay attention when they do this, but these bridges are not glued. They're like a fiddle or a mandolin. They're just sitting there under string pressure. It holds them in place. And they are, if you can see in the camera, they are cut. Try to get it where the light works. There's angles here. You can see that they're not straight. They're cut in a specific way so that the intonation is correct and the B string is in the proper place intonation-wise. They're cut like an electric guitar bridge. This one was installed backwards. So automatically, even though it was in the right place, the intonation was wrong. And so it was way out of whack. And then the frets were screwed up and the neck was warped. So it really didn't play. And the other thing about these bridges, if you see that this shape of the arch top, you can see how it's like that. The bridge is fitted to the shape of the guitar. There's no gap there, so you get this ring. And if you put it on backwards, there is a gap because it's not the same shape going both ways, because these tops are hand carved, so they're not uniform both ways. So that thing is fitted to the shape of the guitar, and you can't take it off of this guitar and stick it on another one because it's not the right shape. You buy them, the bottoms are flat, and you shape it to the guitar. So, anyway, a lot of work goes into these arch tops. Beautiful instrument. Like I said, I thought it was a replica, and even a replica, it was still a beautiful instrument. But like I said, it's either a 40 or a 46. I couldn't narrow it down because Gibson records in the 40s are kind of shady. Some of the numbers, the serial numbers didn't have a code like they do now, where the third digit is the year and all that. It was just a number, like Martin does. Is we made this many numbers that year, and they're kind of hard to track down in the 40s, late 30s and 40s and so on, because Gibson records between then and now, Gibson's changed hands a couple of times, and their records are not great in that time period. So anyway, it is one of those 2 years, so I'll let the owner know that. But I wanted to tell you guys that and share that with you. So have a good week. We will be in Oklahoma City tomorrow. If anybody's out and about in Oklahoma City, come see me. Text me, hit me up on Facebook, whatever. Hit me up on YouTube. And find me because I'm up there and you can say hello. But if you miss me, go and see my friends at Sooner State Pond. And you can see this guitar. Like I said, it is not for sale. It belongs to somebody, but you can still see it. And there are many others that they have in there, some of which I've worked on that are for sale, and they have some great instruments in there. I would prefer, not just because they're my friends, but I prefer to shop in that store rather than go to Guitar Center or one of the other major guitar places, not to knock Guitar Center. But I prefer to shop in Sooner State Pond because they have great deals for one thing, but they also have some really good instruments in there and some good equipment. So good people to go deal with. So anyway, you guys have a great weekend, and I will make a video on Sunday. This was just a little special thing to show you this guitar because I told you I would. So there you go. Enjoy and have a safe weekend, and I'll see you Sunday. Bye.